Hi everyone, I'm Veysel, Gönel, and I'm going to present you our paper which we studied and worked on it with my professor Rüveyda, Kömürlü. Our title is Common Barriers of Green Building Production and Solution Recommendations as an overview. So, in this paper, we have mentioned the green building term, sustainability term, why this came up and what are the barriers that prevents to implement green building technology or green building systems. So, as you know, global warming is an increasing, like it has an increasing percentage of speed and it's becoming more dangerous for our world and construction industry. One of the biggest drivers, maybe the biggest driver of this problem. And what makes construction industry one of the biggest drivers is it causes so much resource consumption, waste generation, hazardous gas emissions, water consumption. And to prevent this, to reduce the impact of construction industry on environment, green building or sustainable building term was found or improved. And then with this, to standardize the production of the green buildings or to determine whether a building is green, like sustainable or not, green building certification systems were found and they're still being found all around the world. And so in this study, we will mention about the, we will mention the most common barriers in the world in developing and developed countries. And I want to start with a description of sustainable development and sustainability. Sustainability is actually, it's different than sustainable development. And in most of the literature, the sustainability was described as sustainable development. I mean, the description of the sustainability was the description of sustainable development, actually. And sustainable development is development that meets the needs of the present generations without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. This description was made in Brundtland report, which was in 1987, and actually sustainability is to maintain the human nature system at a desirable level for current and future generations with the aspect of economic, social and environmental aspects. So these economic, social and environmental aspects are described as triple bottom line in the literature. And so the construction industry, it causes the 42% of energy consumption, 40% of material construction consumption, and 30% is the raw material consumption. It consists of raw materials, 25% of water consumption, 40% of greenhouse gas emissions, 25% of solid waste generation, and 12% of land use is caused by construction industry in the world. However, to reduce all of these impacts on environment, the green building or sustainable building term came up, and it offers us to reduce the energy consumption in buildings while operation, and it can even reduce that during the design, construction and operation. and to reduce water consumption, and it promotes using materials which have a lower life cycle impact on environment, and as I mentioned before, to classify buildings as sustainable or not, there are green building certification systems, and LEED is the main example of that. It was improved in the United States. BREEAM is a British one. It was found in Great Britain. CASBE is another example of that. It's Japanese green building certification system, and BEST is the one in Turkey. So to continue with, this table explains the barriers for different countries, and in the literature there were developing and developed countries, and each had different and similar barriers, and these are the barriers for each country in this table, and this is the rest of the table. So the most common barriers of the green building for production and implementing rating green building certification systems were higher cost. It's the most important, actually, it's the most important barrier. It's generally a barrier in developing countries because money is the biggest concern in developing countries, and it's more like it's more important concern than environmental concerns. And the other second most important barrier is lack of building codes and regulations. And this is actually, it comes with the one of the other barriers of the green building production, which is resistance to change. So it just like this resistance, it just slows down the speed of the improvement of the improvement of codes and regulations, because the experienced professionals are the number of experienced professionals are low, and when they can't have much experience, they can't like the codes and regulations can't be improved. And the other barrier is complexity of green building certification systems. So most of the construction company engineers, designers, architects, they generally get confused with the content of the green building certification systems because they mostly consist of technical information, and the older generation is not really used to that because the green building certification systems are being developed currently and becoming popular currently. The other barrier is lack of experience in construction companies. That actually, as I mentioned, it's because of resistance of the construction companies. They don't want to take risk, and they want to implement the traditional building methods, and this prevents companies to gain more experience. And low demand in the market is another barrier. That is actually because of the lack in consumers' knowledge about the buildings impacts of buildings on environment. Lack of professional is another common barrier in the world, and as I mentioned again, the resistance of construction companies to change is another barrier. And here is the another table, and this table actually suggests possible solution methods for most common barriers of green building production in world. For higher cost, the solution can be governmental support, which can be a reduction of property taxes for certificated green buildings, and reduction of sale taxes for green technology products and green materials in the market. To overcome the barrier of lack of building codes and regulations, creating committees to promote codes and regulations for green building can be a solution. It's a possible solution. Lack of experience in construction companies is another barrier, and to overcome this barrier, educating the company staff with the help of institutions and the universities can be a solution. To increase the demand in the market, educating the public and advertising about the benefits and savings of green buildings to increase awareness can be a solution. And increase the number of professionals in green building production in the construction industry. Companies or government can promote professionals to get educated in green building field by institutions and universities. And to overcome the resistance of construction companies to change from traditional methods to green building technology and green building production methods, government actually can be another governmental support. The governments can promote companies with producing green buildings by reducing the tax in their annual profit. And there is another solution way, which is lean construction method. And this lean construction method, it improves the quality of the construction process and efficiency of construction process, it decreases the construction materials waste, and it increases the efficiency of workforce, and by this way the profit can be maximized and companies can get more profit, and in this way they can reduce the final cost of the projects, and they can reduce the sale price of the buildings they construct, and this way the market prices of buildings will go down and the customers can buy the green buildings in better and easier conditions. So as a conclusion, we explained sustainability term, green building term, and we mentioned the barriers related to economic, governmental, education, organizational, and market. And the biggest barrier was the higher cost of green building production. And this paper was a big step to classify the responsible parties with related barriers to overcome the problems. Thank you for listening to my presentation.